Hello and welcome to this Lumineth Realm Lords painting video. In this video, we're going to be taking you through a step-by-step guide on how to paint two variant steeds of the Vanari Dawnriders. Now, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the models, and as you can see here, we've used grey sear for one and wraithbone for the other. Now, we'll start with the grey sear one first. This is for the light grey colour scheme. Now, the first colour we'll be using is Griffcharger Grey, and we'll be thinning this down with contrast medium. That's two parts contrast medium to one part Griffcharger Grey. So the first thing I'm going to do is grab my medium shade brush and I'll apply couple of dollops of contrast medium and then just one dollop of Griffcharger Grey. So I'm just going to start moving that around. And the reason why I'm putting it on the palette is one to mix it and get a nice consistency, but also I don't overload that brush too much. So get it span like so and then get it to a nice point, and then we're ready to start applying it. So the first thing I do, I'm just going to concentrate around the front here. So I'm just going to start moving that around. And as you can see, I'm doing the horse first because actually it's just a lot easier. So we're not going to concentrate on the armor in this video, it's just the actual horse color scheme itself. There we are, with that contrast and medium mix now dry, we're going to move on to applying some other colours. We're going to start by using grey sear. Now we'll use this as a highlight and also a layer, so on some of those muscle areas we'll just layer that over. Then after that we'll use Griffcharger Grey again. This is for a dapple effect on the neck. We'll also add a little bit more tone to the actual mane and hair on the actual horse, and any deeper recesses that need just more definition. But first of all, let's start with that layer stroke highlight. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette of grey sear, a little bit of water, get a nice point, and then we're ready to start picking out those raised details. So what I'm going to do is start around the face a little bit, and then just like you've got the ears there, so I'm going to do a little edge highlight with that, like so. And then the actual cheek bit here, I'm just going to actually start layering over. So just work your way around the horse, picking those details out. With the highlight and layers now done, we're going to finish off by using Griffcharger Grey to do dapple effects, like so. So all I'm going to start doing is just doing little dots, different sizes, just apply more pressure or less pressure to your brush. And once you've done that, once it's dry, you can always add a little bit more in some of those spots as well, just to add some more definition. And then don't forget to do the mane and any deeper recesses. There we are with the dapple effect now done. Our first steed is completed. So what I want to do now is move on to our second colour scheme. This is more of a beige tone. Now we've started off with an undercoat of wraithbone. Now the first colours we'll be applying is skeleton horde thinned down with contrast medium. So two parts contrast medium to one part skeleton horde. After that we'll use screaming skull as a highlight and a layer. And then we'll finish off with a little bit more skeleton horde, just add some more definition to the mane and some dapple effects as well. So first of all, let's start with that mix. So I'm going to add two paintbrushes of contrast medium and then one paintbrush skeleton horde. Once I've loaded my brush up, then ready to start applying that all over the steed. So all I'm going to do is start on the mane and the head and then just work my way around like so. There we are with the contrast and medium mix now dry. We're going to start layering and highlighting using screaming skull. So I'm going to start layering just little areas here. This is more just to tidy up some of those raised surfaces so they're a little bit less blotchy. When you get to things like the ears, just run a nice fine highlight around like so. You probably only need to do most of the highlighting around the face. So everything else, like the raised areas and the muscles, just layer over. There we are with the layer and highlight now done. I'm going to start doing the dapple effect. Like in the previous colour scheme, we're just going to start doing little dots like so. Just working our way around near the mane. And then once those are dry, I might do some smaller dots and some of the larger little dapples, just to add a bit more definition. Also at this point, it's worth just running some neat skeleton horde over the mane and the tail, and then any darker areas you want to add some more definition to. There we are with the dapple effect done. Our steeds of the Dawnriders are completed. Now by following these two guides, you've got two different colour schemes, but by mixing them into a unit of Dawnriders, we'll add a nice natural effect to that unit. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Steeds of the Dawnriders, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.